What is going on, guys and girls of YouTube? It is me, the Acting Gamer, back with another Call of Duty gameplay commentary for you today. Today what you're going to be watching is a little bit of Fireteam Dirty Bomb gameplay on Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. And I just wanted to give my thoughts and opinions on this game and how it plays. It's a bit of a weird one, really, because I really enjoy this game mode, but I feel that the thing you need to enjoy this game mode is teammates, basically. You need to party up with a couple of friends, three of you at least. I don't think two has cut it. You could probably get away with three and then a randomer, but anything less than three, and unless you just get lucky and you've got a good couple of randomers on your side, which in all fairness in this gameplay I do, but 9 times out of 10 when I'm playing, I just get absolutely terrible teammates. Yeah, so anything less than actual two of you playing, you're going to struggle. So at the minimum you need three. Maximum perfect is to play four. And the way I would basically play this game, as you can see, there's five different dirty bomb sites located around the map, A, B, C, D, and E. Your job as a team is to go around the map collecting uranium, deposit it in the bomb site, and then detonate that bomb. And it's the first person to get to like 350 points or 250 points, I think, is the winning team. As you can see, I'm killing you, collecting uranium. Now a lot of people will collect uranium and then just rush out like a madman trying to deposit it straight away. Using that tactic never works. You can see me, I'm just holding on to this uranium for a minute, waiting for some other people, because I know there's going to be people flying straight back in. You guarantee you down someone, they will just hold X to finish themselves off really quickly. They'll wait like 10 seconds and then they're able to fly back in and try and get their revenge on you. So the way to do this gameplay, like I said, is to just play very cautiously. I think smoke grenades are great in this game mode, because you can just lamp a smoke grenade on that uranium deposit, on that bomb deposit, then you can swoosh in, then go and drop it while you're covered in smoke. That, you will see in this gameplay, works very well for me. I think it is always handy to carry a secondary weapon in this game, like the shotgun, because you do run out of bullets very, very quickly in this game. So you're definitely going to be needing speed mag or fast mag on your gun, as well as a secondary weapon. Here you can see me absolutely depositing the uranium, coming in clutch. I'm just about to arm the dirty bomb, but of course people know that that thing is ready to detonate now, because it comes up on the screen. So you're going to be having loads of teams coming over trying to come and detonate. Luckily my teammate manages to kill the guy who killed me, and then we detonate the bomb. If you and your teammates are all around the bomb, it obviously detonates quicker, but you're at the risk then of all of you just being out in the open and getting shot quite easily. So I would suggest maybe at least two of you on the bomb so it goes a bit quicker, and then the other two teammates kind of on the outskirts watching the guys who are depositing it there back. But other than that, guys, this game mode works really well. Obviously you could find kill streaks around the map. You see me just find an air patrol that came in a care package. I find an RCXT. You can get chopper gunners. There's vehicles in this map, so you can get from, you know, A to D very, very quickly on quad bikes and stuff like that. So yeah, I think this is a great mode. I really enjoy it, especially when you're teamed up with a party of friends. I think it's fantastic. There is a Fireteam Dirty Bomb new map coming in Season 1 next Thursday, I do believe, 16th of July. Obviously, the Season 1 update was meant to be out by now. Cold War integration was meant to be involved into Warzone by now, but they've delayed it, and I can see why by another week, because oh my god, have we got a shitload of content coming next week, and I will be covering all year straight on my channel. The new weapons I will be covering, I will be landing back in Rebirth Island, which is basically the kind of new kind of map they've given us for Warzone with the Cold War integration. Of course, I'll be covering the new multiplayer maps. Raid is coming back from Black Ops 2. We've got Maul at the Pines, so I'll be covering both them here on this channel. And I think we've got a new shotgun, a new SMG, and a new assault rifle. I'm going to be using them all right here on this channel. So make sure you come back next week, the 16th, I think it is, to get you Call of Duty, all the new details covered, because I will be covering them straight away here first on this channel. But as always, guys, I'm just going to pass it back over to the raw footage now. Let me know down in the comment section below, are you playing Fireteam Dirty Bomb? What are you thinking of it? Are you enjoying it? This is what I'm talking about with the smoke grenades here. Literally, smoke grenade down the enemy. I'm in cover there now, and we just managed to deposit the uranium and capture the bomb quite easily. But as always, guys, drop a like, subscribe, all that jazz, and I will see you guys in the next fucking video.
Deliver that uranium to a bomb site. Oye, come mierda, take your uranium to a bomb site. Sit rep, we primed the dirty bomb. We armed the dirty bomb. Enemies have primed a dirty bomb. Be advised, radiation levels rising. Is spreading in this area. Hostile attack helicopter inbound. Net call. Hostile air patrol detected. We armed a dirty bomb. Commencing supply drop. Readings reveal 5 active dirty bombs. Reinforcements are en route. You are letting them steal our victory. Hostile attack helicopter inbound.
Pull the damn plug. Deconflict and move to exfil.
TACCOM, we need to abort mission.